What does Islam teach about women's rights? There is a lot of misunderstanding when it comes to this topic, so thank you for asking this question. Did you know that Islam granted a package of women's rights 1,400 years ago that was unparalleled for over 1,000 years in other parts of the world? Prophet Mohammed taught his followers that the best of them were those who treated women well. He further described men and women as committed partners and helpers to each other, and he himself sought the advice and counsel of women and even appointed women to positions of power, like Shafa bint Abdullah, who he appointed as supervisor of the market or minister of finance. As a result of Islamic teachings, Muslim women were in the marketplace, in the medical field, in positions of scholarship, and more. Muhammad even told his followers, women and men, to learn from his wife, Aisha. And there have been thousands of other great female Muslim scholars and jurists throughout history. In fact, the first university in the world was even built by a Muslim woman in the year 859. Muslim women are surgeons, entrepreneurs, politicians, teachers, lawyers, and more. American Muslim women are the second most highly educated religious community in our country. Like me, I'm a Harvard Law School educated attorney who made partner at a law firm and served as general counsel before leaving my legal career to pursue service. There are American Muslim women like Ibtihaj Muhammad and Dalila Muhammad who have brought home Olympic medals for Team USA. There are American Muslim women who are in Congress now, like Representatives Ilhan Omar and Rashida Tlaib. And even outside the U.S., several Muslim-majority countries have even had female heads of state, like Sheikh Hasina, who is the longest-serving prime minister in Bangladesh. Unfortunately, in many parts of the world, and even here in our own country, women have faced and continue to face oppression and misogyny. In Muslim-majority countries, such injustice is not because of Islamic teachings, but rather despite Islamic teachings that sought to liberate and empower women, as well as all of humanity. Such injustice is because of power dynamics, poverty, warfare, colonialism, post-colonialism, lack of education, bad translations, and more. We agree that women's rights should be upheld. So let's work together to combat misogyny and the patriarchy, but without attacking and demonizing the religion of over 1.7 billion people in the world, especially when that religion could actually help uplift and empower women as it has done and continues to do.